sensor that he was dancing before the Jagannath Ratha, the historian said, and he got some wound on his finger and had some fever, septic fever, and died. So many bhaktas, and everything may be true. Everything may be true simultaneously. So we are also some different type of explanation given, converted into Mahishi, and then some say the Gopi Tala of they dissolve their physical body apparent. And say they disappear suddenly. These are good songs. In this way, if a ghost can appear and disappear, if some yogi can appear and disappear at his sweet will, then what about the Supreme and ego? We can't then, under the jurisdiction of material historic events, then we are deceived. If we go to search in that way, we will be self-deceptive. We must have a faith in the fundamental nature of his existence, who can do anything and everything of the whole living infinite. How he can withdraw to make him a criminal in the court of this might. Law, court. That is wholesome, wrong, and suicidal to the spiritual understanding. The curiosity. In any way he likes. In Vishnu Puran, we find that Krishna died, and the Rukmini and the others in the same fire, they were burnt. That's in another place, the Krishna withdrew from the vision of the ordinary people suddenly. All one and the same. One and the same. The burning into ashes. I had a talk with the greatest acharya of the mantra school in Madras when I was there in charge of the Madras temple. Well, about what is this Srimurti? Srimurti. He told that there is Lord within the Murti. We told that no, the whole cell is the Lord. Shalagram or the Srimurti, not that within the wood or within the minerals or within the earth there is Bhagavan. That was his contention. We told him that the whole cell Bhagavan. Dehi Vibhagoyam Neshwari Vidyate Kvachit. Dehi, the owner of the body, and the owned body, no difference in the case of the Lord. That did not admit. I quoted one slok from Srimad Bhagavatam. And on the basis of that, asked him for the example when Krishna was hit by arrow from a hunter. At that time give the blood ooze from his body, yes, blood ooze. Is that blood material? No. Why not? It is thin in the ear, in the eye, as ordinary blood like that of us. Why do you say that that is that blood only apparent and not real blood, material blood? Oh, if it can be so, then it will be decent. And so also, if we say that if we strike a salagram, it is reduced to pieces. How can it be the whole self? God. So it is also that deceiving our eyes and our experience, our false experience, it is deceiving. We must try to retain in the principle of revealed truth that it cannot be so. Sadhavidanta sarangya bhamatman katsalakkam vastha dhityanta nishtham kai vadvaita prayojanam. The continued consciousness established on the teachings of the revealed scriptures without not allowing our senses of this mundane to venture to major things and the report to our material consciousness. It is so, he is dying in this way, he is passing this way, that way. Neglectfully, kick it out. Stand on the plane of revealed truth. This is all magician's magic. All forgery. And revealed truth, that is real. A continuous stand on that revealed truth. Please, don't allow yourself to be enticed by the so many reaches of such an eye, ear, all these mundane things. This is all magic. It is ridiculous. What do you say? Huh? Is it possible? Only fools can have such faith, credulity, credulity of the highest degree, blind credulity. Is it?
That is what a scholar would say.
Eh?
Now, that is how a scholar, one who is following scholarship, logic.
The whole self-forgery within which we are living at present, whole self-forgery. Nothing to be accepted as truth. This dialogical change, eh? Janisa sabhutanam tasyam jagatihim. Jasyam jagati bhutani sadhisa pashyam. The fool's paradise we are living in. All temporary, all extended from our self-interest. The environment created from our own self-interest necessity, not universal estimation. Are you ready to believe this? We are living in a cage created from within our selfish necessity. Everyone is living in a cage, and so many in a general cage. I am living in a cell, in a cell of a prison house. Another cell. There's some in a broader position, but all confined. And that is hardened by his own evil karma to live in that jail prison house. So all forgery, maya, misunderstanding, miscalculation. Wrong knowledge, no knowledge. Jani prayasudupasya. So we are requested that give up wholesale of your knowledge of experience, beginning with ABC, reject all classes of experience you have gathered so long, of life together. It is all anti-value, all fog, all lie, whole calculation and the whole valuation, everything is false. Try to get relief of that prison and to live in the broad atmosphere of Krishna consciousness. Everything belongs to Him, universal consciousness. Everything belongs to the Master. I am also belong to Him. I must move boldly in such a temperament in the world, or everywhere. This is general, or what we say, that is general. What is brother? Love it. Suffocated. We must be a member of that universal land of one interest, and we will be saved from this suffocating atmosphere. However we do, there is clash with another interest. Every step clash with another interest. This is the mean place to live, meanest of the mean. The widest circle we must move. Everything belongs to my Master. I also belong to Him. Everything is mine because the Master is my own Lord. In this way, in the broadest, widest atmosphere, we shall try to live. Get out of this cage, constructed by your own filthy desire. Gaudhuri. And that is very sweet, very generous, very charming, very blissful, that atmosphere. That is liberation, above liberation, so-called liberation, above. Krishna. Gaudhuri. All guardians, all Vedvishas, parents around us, all affectionate. Not only liberation, but amongst the highest sympathetic atmosphere, all eager to take care of us, long missing links. You have lost my child. I am searching for you so long, where you have been lost. In this way, with affection, they will come to nurture us. How beautiful a life is that! But it's glorious. Nidai Gaudhuri. And Mahaprabhu Nityananda came asked to take there. Nidai Gaudhuri Bodh. And Swami Maharaj said this news to you at the length and the breadth of the world. Carried this news of the highest realized stage to the world. He was chosen to be the Messiah, to the agent of such good prospects for us all. That was taken here by Gauranga Mahaprabhu. This Madhyadham is the bed of such prospect and such knowledge and the hope for us. Here, it came out from Mahaprabhu. And Nityananda Prabhu carried to every door here. This is your home. Back to God, back to home, back to Godhead. Back to Godhead, back to home. And home is such. Or is traveling endlessly, misguided by your own hobby. Gaushundar, Gaushuri, 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 Nidai, Gaushuri, Gaushuri, Nidai, Gaushuri, Gaushuri. The time after the week, being old. Pangurung lang hai ki. There was one Indian big scholar whose name was Bhajan Singh. About 50 years back, an international religious conference in Italy, perhaps, and he represented Indian philosophers, Mr. Singh, good scholar. But ultimately, he became mad. So, intellect is not reliable. The reaction may come to madness. Affection is sustained of life. Keep the balance. Love. Without love, intellect is mad. Affection, soothing, lahadini shakti. Sacrifice. Keep the balance. Bow. Is Bhargava Prabhu? Where is he?
Here.
You have no admission of discovering the last day's history of Christ in Kashmir. And no program.
I've heard that story.
You have heard the story?
A little bit.
What is that?
That there is a grave in Kashmir.
When?
Christ is resting there, and that he has a descendant that is still living there.
Day of crucifixion and day of resurrection, what is it? So after 4 days, he came out of the cave, it is told.
After 3 days,
his body was put in a cave.
Yes.
And after 3 days, when some people went to find what is the condition of his body, they found that he no trace is there. He has fled from there.
Yes.
And then he came to Kashmir from there. And for some time, what is this story?
So he became householder and he preached there. They published one book in English. They published one book in English. I think his name was Isha. In Kashmir, they called him Isha.
Isha. Isha is also called among the Mohammedan section. Isha, Musha. Isha, Jesus. Jishu, Ishu, Isha. Isha, the Muslims consider him as Isha. I don't know, the predecessor is Musa, Musha, Moses. And then Abraham, all these in the line of the Muslim Guru Parampara. So Isha is considered as one of the prophets in the line of the Muslims. They include him as the divine angel, divine agent. Their condition, the last agent from heaven is Muhammad. And he is the greatest, and no other representation from heaven will come. The last representative from the heaven is Muhammad. That is. But all other spiritual teachers, they are common to Christian and Mohammedan. Isha. Isha, Musha. Jesus, Moses, and Abraham, and so on. Abraham, they say he is Brahma. Vedic Brahma, Abraham, Brahma. Similar sound. Uru Poras, Pythagoras, Pithiguru, Pythagoras. Poras, in Greek, Poras, in Sanskrit, Puru. Guru is Goras. In this way, the Greek language from Sanskrit comes to this. Hamburg, and England is Hamburg. Bagburg. Germany they say Burg. Hamburg, Saint Petersburg. But the English pronunciation Hamburg, Saint Petersburg. So also, the Puru, Purus, Poras, Guru, Goras, in this way. Pitar, it's a Pitar, Sanskrit is Pitar, and in English, Greek perhaps it is Pitar, Mother. Sanskrit is matar. Matar, matri shabda. Matar, mata, mataru, matara. Matar, original sound is matar. And mother, similar. Pitar, bratar, a brother. Sasri, sasar, a sister. All coming, similar. Sanskrit. And the Greek, for us, Greek root. and Kashmir, Kashmiran Sea, Kashyap. The father of the gods was Kashyapa Rishi. And indeed his name was Kashyap, so Kashyapa God, Kashmiran Sea. At that time, this portion of India was under ocean, Indian Sea. And the, now the Himalayan peaks, they are down, now they are up. Himalayan is going up. And the neighboring land is also coming up. This was underwater, and that portion lower, and there the Indian civilization on the Himalayas. When Ambarish Maharaj was living, he was the king, emperor. At that time he performed his hundreds of sacrifices on the banks of Saraswati, which is near Badrikasram at present. So high. That's the Rasastram, Badrikasram. And that's the composed Bhagavatam. Ready to Shukadev, Devaksi Narad came. That is so high now, that was down. Himalaya is going up gradually. And the area of India is also increasing. So many differences in geographic condition. No stability. Just as our mind, sometimes this, sometimes that, so the whole this matter, rigid matter also is like that. First one scholar told, first from Germany for us, that all these lands are floating. Floating. They, on the ocean somewhere, it is floating. Coming together and going away in this way, this land. Africa was joined with America. Some earthquakes, bigger earthquakes, separated them. Because they say that the trees on the west side of Africa is similar to those of the America, east side of America. And also the hill that was broken, half portion, some portion this side, another portion that side. And if joined together, they will be one. So Atlantic has come between by some earthquake and separated America from Africa. They say like that. And India was somewhere in the Indian Ocean. And then you have a big flow driven by storm or something. They pushed this Himalaya. And up to Tibet, that was on the other side. And the other, this part of in the whole India has come, led by a great storm and pushed this side and the other. These are the opinions of the present geologists. Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol.
Is that reasonable, Guru Maharaj?
Maybe. We are not much concerned with that. One who has withdrawn in the mental system has got some relation with this effect of this mental with more going upward, no necessity of all these things. It will look. The sun is supposed, the moon is supposed to be the resting place of the soul after death. who is again to return here. This is Lok. In Gita, two kinds of going, arise after death, Uttarayan and Dakshinayan. Chandamasam Jyoti Yogi Pratmani Vartati. Go up to moon and then come back. That moon is a upagrahi satellite, sorry. It is moving around the...
Yes, satellite of the earth.
Around the earth. So, after death, those mental systems are going to the moon and may take some rest for some time there to come back here. And those that are living, they have no chance for the earthly pleasure, they will go towards the sun. They will cross the line of gravitation. And they cross, go towards the sun, towards the light, Uttarayan. Sannasam Dakshinayanam, Sannasam Uttarayanam. And Yogi Prakpana Vistate. That's the Chandamasam Jyoti. From moon, they will come back. But those that are going towards sun, they won't come back to this earth. They go somewhere, more luminous place. They will go and take their physical form and live. Crossing their gravitation limit of earth. Towards light means towards knowledge. Light means knowledge, consciousness. And moon means mind, our mental tendency with attraction for the earthly pleasure, worldly pleasure. I go up to moon and then come back. Because attracted by worldly pleasure. And who has no charm for worldly pleasure, they will go beyond the jurisdiction of the earth and towards infinity, catching the ray of the light, consciousness, soul, super soul, light. And Chandra, moon, the charm of the earth. They are under, caught under the charm of the worldly pleasure, earthly pleasure. They go up to the moon and come back. The moon's appearance is a good contribution to the earthly charm. Mental pleasure, here I find. We have to scrutinizingly find the difference between the layers of knowledge. Layers of bhu, bhuva, maha, jana, tapa, satya, viraja, brahmalu, vaikuntha, guloka. These layers, different position, different planes of charm. Ultimately, we are charmed by something and become slave to that. So everything has got its own specific charm. And we have to compare and to dismiss and accept. Eliminate and accept. What is the peculiarity of bhūlok? Then what is bhūvalok, mahalok, janalok, tapalok, satyalok, which is within the jurisdiction of exploitation. Gradually, exploitation is being lessened. decreased. In Shottalok, slight attraction for pleasure, for exploitation, least exploitation in the Shottalok. More conscious of eternal position of the soul, independent of material acquisition and enjoyment. This is not like the enjoyment of these material things. More self-sufficient Atmaram. They find more pleasure in their own, in the perception of their own self, Atmaram. Ramanti means they feel pleasure in him, in their own soul. More or less they find, they can find the nature of their own soul and are satisfied with that, Atmaram, self-satisfied. That is found in Shottalok mostly, Atmaram, self-satisfied. They can realize the position of their own soul, no material body, so no exploitation is necessary to preserve this material body. And they are charmed by the beauty of their own soul, and more or less engaged they are. Atmarama, who is finding pleasure in his own self, eternal self. Then Atmaramastamunayo nirgantatvuko kulbantahaitu kimbhaktin ittham bhuto guna hari. Then those that are self-satisfied, that are found in the last extremity of this exploiting world, self-satisfaction, not dependent on the exploitation of this material world, they have got some charm over their plane, and they find Hari there. Hari is such that can attract the attention of those that are self-satisfied. So Atmaram, that is a conception of liberation. Liberation from the exploiting tendency of the environment. Self-centered, self-sufficient. They feel attraction for some other thing, since that thing must be superior to the human self, to the self. Otherwise, how those that are self-content, their attention can be drawn, that must be finer. So it is a proof that Hari is not this side of the world, but on the higher side. Atmaramaste munayun irgantha obhi urukkame kubvayin tarayin tukin bhaktin. Causeless attraction they feel for Hari. Then Hari Ras, the ecstasy which we can get in connection with Hari, in association with Hari, that must be of higher degree than what we find in our own self. Prayena munayo rajam vivitya vishedata nasgunnasta ramante sma vinam gunam katami hari. These are the proofs that Hari is not missed this side. Within the natural production, as the Shankarites, Mayavadins say, it is nirguna, it is beyond. Prayena munayo rajam nivitta vishesata nirguna staramante isma jnana kata. They are nirguna, they do not care for this sattva-rajatama. They are opposing it such, still they find some expression and the discourse about Hari. So Hari must be on the higher side. In this way. Tadushan Dasyāra-vindam, anasya-palāra-vindam. Yogeshwari-sri-vijinta-magādha-bhūti. Nā-kinyal-kanishta-tulsi-makaranda-vāyu. Antargata-savivare-na-cakāra-tesam. Pankoba-makāra-tesam. Dī-tulsi, which was placed in the as contact with the holy feet of Narayana, that scent disturbed these people who are Atmaram Chatushama, were self-sufficient, self-satisfied. Their attention is attracted by the sweet scent of the Tulasi, which is, has got contact with the feet of Narayana, holy feet. That attracted, snatched away, so that must have some superior position. In this way, it has proved to be given that Vaikuntha is over Brahma and not this side Brahma. As the Shankarais, Mayavadins, they argue. Sukadeva also says, Parinishthitopi Naikunye Uttamasu Kodigaya Vinita Keta Raja Sri Akhanam Yada Vidavam. O Maharaj Parikshit, you all know that I am well established in Nirguna Brahma, that beyond my position is proved that I am beyond the charm of this mundane world. You all know. All know. The 10% I have no charm for any material temptation. Still, I had some special charm to hear about the Leela of Krishna, Vrindavan. My attention was forcibly matched to us. So that must be on the other side, on the higher side of this world. That is not in, among the pleasing tastings of this mundane world. And these are the witness, evidence, that Krishna Leela is a prakrita, is a rūpṣaja, is transcendental. These are the proofs, that those that have done no charm, the least charm of this mundane pleasure, they reverentially attracted towards that similar things that is very high on the other side of the Brahma, Parabrahma world, and not this Monday. Hallucination, intoxication, hallucination, dangerous. It may draw our attention to any side and every side. These are the sound calculations towards the transcendental Leela of Krishna, Vaikuntha, etc. And we must strictly follow, stick to this sort of judiciousness and judgment. Otherwise we may be misled, misguided. Who is Christ? Who is Muhammad? What is their position? Who is Shankara? Who is Ramanuja? Who is Chaitanya? What is their subtle differences? We have to measure by these standards of subtle knowledge and differences between the standards. Very scrupulously and very discriminately we have to follow all these, to examine all the speciality of these different layers or planes of existence. If we miss them, then our brain will reel and anything and everything we shall accept in the name of anything and everything. Puzzled, perplexed, in systematic study, strong. Strong and very accurate differences between the different layers of thought must be maintained, must be followed, must be understood. Otherwise, we are in danger. Any moment, anyone may say, oh, I have finished all these things, this is all nothing. What Karnak said, that is well and good. In this reaction. Sincere, seven mukh, generally we must try to understand the three, the nature of three planes. The land of exploitation, plane of exploitation, renunciation, and service, dedication. We have to clearly understand the nature of these three planes, plane of exploitation, plane of renunciation, and the plane of education. Then we have to calculate. And if we understand the valuation, proper valuation of these planes in general, then in fine points also we can try to calculate how much renunciation, how much exploitation, how much dedication is missed in this, then valuation. We must be well versed in the intrinsic knowledge of these three planes first, and then the position and how the development by degree is possible. In a mathematical way. Then we cannot be removed from our present fixed position. As a way, we are uncertain. Anyone may convince, try to convince, and I will be a prey to his whimsical representation. Today I am a Pentonite, the other day I am a Shankarite, the other day I am Buddhist, another day I am Islam, another day I am atheist. No stability. Gaur Hari Bol. Nidai Gaur Hari Bol. Someone is, what was that gentleman for whom we sent some money to come back from Kashmir? What was his name? 400 rupees was sent to him?
Yes.
To come back?
Yes, one of Tirtha's disciples.
Tirtha's disciple?
Or no, actually he was Prabhupada's disciple, but he was came with Tirtha.
He went to find out the place where Jesus was very George, Jesus preached or something. That tendency entered into his brain. Living Harinam and honest prayer, how he may be relieved of this worldly troublesome engagement, how he can take me on the higher position in the devotional school. As master of his own, he has no engagement from Krishna. He is master of his own, and he is wandering here and there according to his own whim. Jivir Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das, you have got no independence. The connection between you and the center, it is not negligible. It is a high power connection. If you come in a normal position, you will feel that the strongest attraction from you to the center, and we can't ignore if you come in the normal position. Normal position. If the outside dresses are removed, you will find that the greatest attraction from the center within you, and you can't go astray, aside. Your duty, you are always, your bounden duty to be set from there, and you have to discharge that. This cannot but be in your normal position. You will find the greatest attraction force from you and the center. Whatever would be required, would be demanded from you from that quarter, you cannot but do that. That should be the normal position. But you are independent, you can do this, no bad work kind, no engagement, wandering everywhere. We sarupai Krishna Nitya Das, when we are completely free, completely free, completely we are independent of the associated forces, then we shall only realize that I am bound down, duty bound towards the center. I cannot go hither and thither at my own sweet pleasure and lead to the center. Central connection with every part, normally it must cannot be such, must be such. But we think we are free, we are doing here and there. That means neglected by the center. Away from the center. And that not just the dust will be clear, we shall have to feel it. The call of the center within me, and I will be really engaged. No time to waste, really engaged. I shall have to fight. It is not unreasonable. The center's demand is absolute in me. And I shall have to feel that, that I have got full engagement there in the, from the head of it. No time to waste my time wondering this one, that one, and this. Sotudyadini Rajantra Ninang Santi Sahasrasa. In Bhagavatam Sukadeva, in the beginning, he says, thousands of things to hear, to attain, to do, to, for whom? For those unfortunate, neglected souls. They have got their thousands of engagements in different ways. But to the normal, only one. Directed to us, connected with the center. They will find that one engagement, all self captured by him. That duty has captured me wholly, not to get outside. Really it is so. Much scattered we are, our Lord is such. No duty, thousands of duties. Thousands of witches are attracting our attention and we are running after this land. That is the worst condition in us. Avashyatam Atmatattam, who does not know his own self, he has got thousands of engagements, hundreds of engagements. Avashyatam Atmatattam, who cannot see his own self. And thereby, the realm in which his soul is living. and thereby the center of the plane where he is living, or is known. Swarupa Vibhavam, all from our own self-interest. So we must understand this exploitation of different types and renunciation and dedication of twofold, one calculative, another spontaneous. Then we have to calculate in details what is what. A new proposal will come, I am to put in the map. What is the similarity? It must be posted there. This is in Karma Kanda or Vikarma, or Jnana Kanda or Yoga Kanda or Vini Bhakti or Raga Bhakti. We have to sort just as in the post office, the sorting department. This will go in the foreign land. That is one compartment. These parcels will go to foreign land and must put them in. So this is in the local somewhere. Then in this district, that district, that district. Compartmental position somewhere will put that according to the address. So also we shall have to know whatever new things will be given to extended to me. So this is this, that thing. It must go into that category. In the Vikarma, or in the Karma, or in the Yoga, or in Vaikuntha, or in the we must examine it, the opinion, the plan, the design that will be given to examine and put him in a particular position. We must have a world map. The whole thought. The exhausted thinking world, a map of that we must possess, and we'll understand what is what. So many diverse things, the rural, demanding the yen, the sterling, the dollar, how to adjust, come to adjust, everything is independent, then some gold, common standard must be there, and with that we have to measure. What is the measurement of dollar, what is of rupee, what is of sterling, is this thing a common criterion we have to secure. And this this exploitation, denunciation and dedication, if we understand them properly, that will help us a great deal there. We have to understand properly what is the value, what is the worth of the exploitation, denunciation and dedication. These three fundamental things, trinity, and the thinking, feeling, willing. Satyam Shivam Sundaram. Satchit Andam. These fundamental principles of life and the environment. The basis we must have to understand. Properly, rightly. Gold, holy gold, gold, holy gold, gold, holy gold. I am Krishna, I am Mahamad, I am Jishu, I am everything. Now I am one thing, next moment I am another thing. This is anarchy in the religious world. And the greatest enemy may not have such misfortune. we shall pray to the Lord. The nun may have such misfortune, lost in the calculation world, besides sense of derangement. Gauri Hari Gaur, that is horrible. Horrible to think that madness may not attack us in any position. Lord, save me. O Lord, save us. Anything we have. Anything and everything we have. We have no safe, skinny souls that give us shelter under your cool, under the, within the shadow of your cool, holy feet. We are not safe. Allow us, give us admission within your fold and sustain us. Sustain us. We are so teeny. We are so meager, so teeny, so helpless. So, I must fallen of the fallen. So I am qualified for your mercy. Accept me. Bravo. Ocean of grace you are. I am uncertain in my present position. Dhammacharya says, Lord, I think I am quite normal in this time. I sign a bond that I am your servant, take care of me. And this bond should apply in future for me. I may be otherwise in future. Now I am in full consciousness. I am giving this bond to you. Please protect me. Next moment I may be otherwise. I can't say. So if in future I want something else, you won't allow. I am in my fullest, perfect knowledge at present. That you are my all, you give me admission. The next moment I may do something else, but that won't be granted. I am giving sign. The Jamunacharya, Guru of Ramanuja, he says like that, so much uncertain our position. Next moment I may see something else, but don't allow my Lord, you are my guardian, and it is final. You take my charge. So alert, so suspicious of his own self. Jivatma is so subtle and so meager, and so helpless. He is sweet. With this attitude we shall go to take refuge, to take shelter under the holy and shade of the Lord, holy feet. We want to be this fast. We shouldn't. That is our service. Go, Hari, go. Nidai, go, Hari, go, Nidai. You are my guardian. I realize this moment that fully. And I don't like that it may be otherwise. It is horrible. Nidai, go, Hari, go. The Yamunacharya, I can't remember the shloka in Sanskrit. It is there. Mukunda Mala Soktama Samaya. Have you come across this shloka? You, Bhargava Prabhu?
Yes.
Mukunda Mala.
Mukunda Mala Soktama.
Do you remember about this shloka there?
By
Yamunacharya. Very good advices are that in Kulasekhar Acharya, Kula Maharaj Kulasekhar, who was perhaps in the first century AD of Christ, king of Kerala, Trivandrum, Kulasekhar, Alwar. He also, his prayer to Narayan is also very fervent and very encouraging and educating. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Gaur Hari, Gaur Hari, Gaur Hari, Gaur Hari. Nidhai Gaur Hari Gaur, Nidhai Gaur Hari Gaur, Nidhai Gaur Hari Gaur, Nidhai Gaur Hari Gaur.
Jamunacharya was charmed by his kingdom so much.
Huh?
Jamunacharya.
Jamunacharya? Yeah.
He was a king.
At present time condition. he got that. He was a student. You know his story? No.
Yeah. Little.
Hmm?
You can tell?
He was a student in a school. And the king, the then king, had a court pandit. He was very much proud. He issued a circular to all the local pandits to this effect. You accept me as the paramount scholar, best of all. Otherwise you come to me and discuss. You will have to discuss with me. I want to defeat you all. The circular came to the teacher, head teacher of the school where Yamunacharya, the boy, was reading. He was well talented. He asked, his guru was going to give his signature. That I admit that you are superior scholar. The Yamunacharya approached, what is this? Guru explained, teacher, the court pandit has issued this circular. If anyone thinks to give his signature, that he is the greatest scholar. If not, then he must go and discuss with him and defeat him. So Yamunacharya told, no, you must not give his signature. The boy. Why not? What is the good by quarreling with the court pandit? He will stop our the help, monetary help from the state help. State help he will stop and we will have to suffer. So I am giving this. No, no. As your representative, I shall go. And he was so determined, the guru had to accept that. Yes, if you like, you may go. Then all other teachers, they gave their signature. And this Jamunacharya went to discuss with him, the boy. There was a great commotion in this state that one boy is coming to discuss with the court pandit, the state scholar. There was a great uproar. And when the boy is going, the king and the queen, they are also seeing from their within the room. Within the room through the window, the distant boy. The queen was very much charmed with the appearance of the boy. I say the boy will conquer for this fight. The king says, it is not certain. No. Then there was a debate between them. If the boy wins the pill, what do you do? I take this debt, what is this? That my daughter will be married with him and the half of the kingdom will be given to him. But the king hesitated, and anyhow that was accepted. And when in the assembly the boy and the old pandit were together, the pandit, the court pandit, he felt much excitement. There are so many pandits in the country, scholars, but this boy has come to debate with me. Hey boy, whatever question he will put, I shall cut it asunder. Say what is. The boy put 3 points. I put these 3 questions to you and you must cut it asunder. First thing I say, that your mother is not barren. You will have to prove that your mother is barren. Do you follow? Barren?
Yes.
Woman does not produce a child. Yes. She is known as barren, is it not?
Yes.
I say your mother is not barren. This is my question. You say that you will crush it, smash it. The next I say that the king is free of sin. No, not sinful. King is not sinful. You will have to prove that king is a sinner. And the third and the greatest, I say that queen is chaste. And you have to prove that queen is not chaste. A dreadful thing. That pandit, he could not answer. And he began to sweat, trembled, and the whole family there also, waiting with suspense, what's the matter, come in future? These 3 questions. Then anyhow, the court pandit, he told, can you answer these questions? This is all fallacious, nonsense. It is not proper questions at all. Can you answer? Yes, I can. Then the whole audience began very acute. You will answer this boy. Then he quoted scripture that mother can be called barren if his son is very worthless. Quoted from some cipher, worthless cipher, then mother may be called a barren. He quoted from some scripture, and then the silence, great silence, what is it? The next, the king is a sinner. Tell the truth, the king is always accepting the court, The money which is given to the
king?
Taxes. Taxes of the people. Always drawing taxes. And with that taxes, the sin from the Raja Praja of the people is coming to the king. And the king performs so many religious works to get out of the sin. But they always current. The taxes from the so many people are coming to the king, and their sin is always coming to the king with that money. So, in this all quotation from the scripture, so king is sinful, and to remove the sin he will have to take to so many sacrifices and other holy duties. It is in the scripture, he quoted that quotation. Then thunderstruck, then lost and resist. That queen is unchaste, lady. Horrible thing to prove. That also he came. That with the king, it is mentioned in the scripture, 8 gods are always living with the king, Indra and Chandra, etc. The king is the combination of all these gods. They always stay with him. So, when king enjoys the queen, those gods are also there. We gave quotation. And none can oppose. So you want the day, then the queen king was satisfied, and as they had their debates within them, came with the princess as well as the half portion of the kingdom. As given, and the Yamunaj Arjo was king for some time, and neglected the culture of the Shastra and the Vaishnava school, all these things. And he was enjoying. So, one Acharya of the Ramananda school, he was very much mortified and wanted to visit the king. But it was not very easy to have his darshan, his interview. So, that Yamunacharya was fond of some vegetable, too much fond. So he used to collect that sort of vegetable every day to his kuka. Then one day Yamunacharya asked his cook, how do you get this sort of vegetable? This is very, I am very much fond of this vegetable. But it is difficult to collect this vegetable all the season. But you give it supply, how do you get? One old Brahmin, Vaishnava, he takes this thing for you every day. Is it? Yes. Ask him what is his object, what not. Then he was asked, he told that I want his interview. Yes, yes. So the interview was arranged, and the Brahmin met him and began to cry. Why you Brahmin, you are crying? What wrong I have done to you, I don't know. You have done a great wrong to our society. He was such a young, great Pandit, a giant intellect, and you have left us here and lived in your pleasing life, pleasure life. You got a princess, you got a half kingdom, you are madly enjoying them. And what about our sampradaya? This sampradaya? The other party, Shankar party, they are trying their best to humiliate our sampradaya. And you, being a genius of our sampradaya, you are sleeping over the interest. that disturbed him. Yes, Brahmi, you have given me yes, light. Now I shall try. So therefrom he began to read the Shastra and the right books, all these things, service of the Ramanuja Vaishnava Sampradaya. He engaged himself. And in the last days, when Ramanuja was a rising boy, a scholar, he could not meet him anyhow. But he had three found three necessity things for the Sampradaya. One, the commentary of Vedanta, another, the worshipping notes by how the deities should be worshipped, and another, the interpretation of all the Upanishads. Then, in last days, he removed himself to Sri Rangam, and there he sent for Ramanuja, that I want to meet him and to request him something for the benefit of our Sampradaya. But before Ramanuja could come to meet him, he breathed his last. Ramanuja came and found that he is already gone. But he sent for him for particular purposes, he already told. Three objects. Ramanuja detected his body and found 1, 2, 3, these fingers closed. Then he told Ramanuja, who thought the meaning. There is a custom in that country to count one thing, this 1, 2, 3, in this way, closing the finger. He detected the three things, three fingers closed, so he could read the three things he had to say to me. So he also, living in the common platform, to do some service to the society, Vaishnava society, so Ramanuja could feel what three things he was to convey to Ramanuja. He told, I shall prepare commentary to the Upanishads, one finger become straight. I shall also prepare a bhashya to Vedanta, the next finger. I shall prepare a ritual worshipping book for the service of the deity, the third finger also to direct. Then people were very much surprised, and they began to cry joy of Ramanuja and accepted him as the leader, though a boy, Ramanuja. This is Chamunajaj, and he wrote some Sanskrit verses, which is considered to be the, in the line of very pure devotion. Pure devotion. This Yamunajaja, Kulasekhar Ramanuja, and the one Sathagopa, that is in Tamil only. Jaisikajaji, so many Chalvas in the Puresh Alwar, all the Chalvas of the Ramanuja Sampradaya. Shuddha Bhakti, pure devotion, we can trust on them. Free from contamination of Mayavad, Soham. We are one. We are of the same status with the Absolute. That's wrong conception of Shankar. The difference is great. And he is master, we are man. Man and the master. That condition, that is more acceptable and palatable thing for us. We are uncertain. Our position without Islam is uncertain. And when we are in the pole of this devotional area, then we can fight most. Anything is there. Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol, Gaur Hari Bol, Hai Gaur Hari Bol. Vidai Gaur.
Right.
Yes.
How is it that the Vedas declare Krishna as a Nitya Brahmachari?
What?
The Shruti declare Krishna as Nitya Brahmachari.
As?
Nitya Brahmachari.
Nitya.
Brahmachari.
Yes.
How do you get this? Nakashra is Brahmachari, and that's Gopal Tapani.
Yes.
Yes. That story.
In the Upanishad.
Do you know that the story? The gopis are observing some vrata, bhav, and fasting. And after feeding a Brahmin, then they will break their fast. See, they went to the other side, want to go to Durvasa Ashram, and the Jamuna River is between, and the Jamuna was in full-fledged tribulation. What is the first and the next? Durvasa Bhavashi. Then, perhaps they came to Krishna. How we can cross this Jamuna? We have got such bhav. We want to go there. Then Krishna told them, advised them, you go to Jamuna and say that Krishna is Brahmachari. And Jamuna, he will be able to cross Jamuna. And they went to Jamuna and there, folded palms, Krishna Brahmachari give us way to cross on. And they crossed on and they did not dive there. Then after feeding the Durvasa and his disciples there in a good way, then they asked Durvasa how we can cross this turbulent Yamuna. How did you come? We came with this word, that Krishna Brahmachari, he told. We told like that and then we came. Then you go and say to Yamuna, Durvasa Upavasi. Durvasa is observing fast. What is this that you, we are feeding you so many things and you